Hello everyone, welcome back to Gyanarthi. So today we are going to discuss how to read newspaper in order to improve our English speaking skills. Okay, this is basically for the people who want to enhance their English speaking skills over and above, you know, the general knowledge or the fact that some children prepare for government exams and they read newspapers as well, but their approach is a bit different. And you are not watching this video from the motive of cracking any government exam. You're watching this video from the motive of enhancing your English speaking skills. For your GK portion, we'll make a separate video. Now this video will highlight the fact of how should we read the newspaper so that it enhances our English speaking skills in the most fluent and most easiest way. Okay, so first thing that you have to do is you have to chalk out what is really important in the newspaper. Now, when you chalk out what is really important in the newspaper, it becomes easier for you to read it, because what happens is you will develop interest. For example, what is important? Important may vary according to a person. For example, some young girls, especially, you know, 90 to 22 years of old, they might have a mixed approach of studying these magazines and these English magazines which highlight fashion, as well as the trend of your current affairs, which helps you, okay, which helps you in your day-to-day life, or the science and tech, something like that, okay, or based on their graduation or their research work. So girls might take this approach. This is a generalized thing. Exceptions are everywhere, so we are not talking about that. Okay. Now, secondly, boys might have an approach of, you know, reading the newspaper from sports point of view. Like IPL is going on, they like Indian Premier League a lot. And they, again, what they are studying relevant to that. Basically, the situation in India is most of the youth, they don't really read newspaper, and that is, I don't think, a very good thing, because one should read newspaper from the perspective of knowing the world also. It is a very important thing. Everyone should read newspaper. That is why you would have seen the old people in your home, in your house, your grandparents, especially your grandfather, because grandmother from that time are not that literate in, I guess, the middle class scenario. But that's again a generalized thing. You might be having grandmothers who might be much more educated than your grandfathers, so don't bash me. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to take a newspaper, a good newspaper. Always remember, when you take a newspaper, take a very good newspaper. And in India, if there's a good newspaper, I think the newspaper I follow is The Hindu. Although The Hindu is a bit, and means, you know, it doesn't support the rightist ideology, which is currently the government in our country. It criticizes it a lot, even on good things, I feel sometimes, but it's okay. We are not here to build our criticism. We are here to improve our English. So we are going to target the best, okay? We are going to target our best. And mind it that the newspaper is a bit expensive. I guess it's 12 to 14 rupees on normal days, and on Sunday, I guess it is 16 rupees or something like that. Okay, so you can do one thing. Either you can take it online. You can take an online subscription. It costs a bit less. Or else, because what happens is, The Hindu is not available in high-tier areas and not in every part of the country. It's not available. Okay, so you have to chalk up the ways of how you will take it. And in case if you can't arrange The Hindu, or you find it a bit expensive from your expenses side, you can start with Hindustan Times or the Times of India. That is also a very good beginning. In fact, I will say the people who are starting from like below average or something, that below average as in who wants to build their concept, for whom the concept of English speaking, I'm talking about speaking, not the tenses, not the language part. Okay, what they can do is they can take from Times of India or Hindustan Times, because The Hindu is a bit humongous thing. It's very, the English used is quite very, very devastating, to be honest, if you take it on the first day. Okay, and now when you are reading, if you want to prepare for any government exam, start it from the editorial page. If not for any government exam and only for, you know, for English speaking skills or something like that, take from any part of the newspaper. But mind it that the news should have some value for you. okay, it should not be like that, you know, that someone killed someone over there or something like that, because it's bring a sort of negativity and it will not enhance your journal knowledge or something like that. When we are doing something, at least it should bring knowledge to us. Okay, it should not be unnecessary, right? So you don't have to study the unnecessary part. Go for the necessary part. Okay, like you can read editorial, you can read about the politics that is going on. It is really interesting right now, so you can go for that. Okay, you can go for all the tribunals, the river tribunals. They are almost every second day in news. Okay, so what is the role of tribunals or something like that, if you are really interested. If you're not interested, just go for what brings interest to you, but abstain for something which is not useful to you. Okay, because when we are doing something, we should have a value addition. Okay, so this is how you're going to study newspapers. Secondly, when you find any word which you don't understand, okay, which you don't understand, write it down. Look at its meaning, okay? And when you look for a meaning of a word, no, you don't remember it the first time. You have to actually look for it 2-3 times. Then only that word and the meaning of that word will be clear to you in your mind. So what you have to do is write the words at one place, write their meanings or search their meanings 2-3 times. And after that, doing that, try to use those words in your vocabulary, okay? Try to use those words in your vocabulary. This is going to, you know, do tremendous, you know, tremendous development for your English speaking. It's, seriously, trust me, this is going to be very helpful to you. Okay, so this is how you're going to read your newspaper, and rest, we'll meet in the next video. Thank you so much. Bye.